like to discuss with about first derivative test. Okay, normally we use this for if you get yourself into big graph. Most likely a quadratic, this one or this one. And if you do the critical point where you do dy dx equals to 0, let's take a look. One. Let's say your y is x cubed minus 3x squared plus 6. Dy dx is 3x squared minus 6x. Yeah, plus 0 equals to 0 if you like equals to 0. So now we get ourselves 3x, x minus 2 to 0. So x equals to 0 and 2 is there. Critical point. Zero and two. You can check the y as well. The problem is we have no idea which type of graph are we going to have. Is it this one or oopsie? This one. What's the difference between left and right? I mean, the first one is the max, second one is the min, or maybe you can say relative. This one is the relative min, this one is the relative max. So we are not sure which of these will you have. Okay, so that's the main idea. You want to know which one. Of course, you can use the second derivative, the square y, the x squared, for you to check which one is max, which one is mean. But there are some situations where the second derivative test cannot give you the answers. And then, of course, sometimes the exam can be a bit naughty and ask you about, hey, find it by using the first principle, first derivative test. Right? So, if you want to do first derivative test, you cannot run far away from here. Okay, let's say this one is the mean. And we want to check the dy dx a point before. Okay, let's say if here is a 0 and 1. Maybe let's say 1. Let's take it like 1, 2. So a point before that will be what? X-axis, this x. Let's say it's 1, here it will be 0. A point after this will be? Let's say 2. So you need to check at the point before and after for the x-axis. Okay? Do you care about the y? No, just for the x. You need to put the value 0, you need to put the value 2 inside the equation and see what's going to happen. Okay, if we got ourselves a negative value, we got ourselves dy dx equals to negative. So it means it's a negative gradient. We got ourselves dy dx equals to the positive. So that means it's a positive gradient. So you can see negative to positive.
So this one becomes the mean. That's the mean idea.
So let's say for this one, let's say this is a 3 pi.
So what's the point before that?
Let's say 2, point after.
4.
That's 4. And at this point here, if you got yourself dy dx equals to positive. Over here you get yourself dy dx equals to the negative. So you can see the graph, it's a positive, it's negative.
So you're gonna turn something like that. That's the main idea. Until that, are you guys okay? Till this, are you okay? This is the main idea.
So if we go for this equation, this is where we're going to find a critical point. So your critical point is 0 and 2. Where should you sub this one to? The y or the
first derivative?
First derivative,
the dy dx. Okay?
So
let's rewrite a few things back. So now you let. Okay, ours is 0 and 2. If you make another line, 0 and 2. So which number should you test? Somewhere.
Negative.
Okay, this is the maximum minimum. This is the point. You need to choose a number before and after.
Negative.
Before and after. So what's your before and after?
Negative 1.
Negative
1.
Maybe like with a different color. Ours is 0 and 2, the critical point.
Okay, let's have one example for us.
Okay, so we got ourselves positive, negative, negative. So we can say this one is the max. This one is the mean. But we cannot write our answer just like that. You need to check 0, 1. So this 0 and this 2, you need to substitute inside the first equation to the y. So you get yourself 0, 6. I got 6 by substituting inside the first equation. 0, 6. And the other one is 2, 2, the same way. This one is the relative max. This one is the relative mean.
Okay, relative this means by comparing to something else. It's not means adik beradik or siblings. And why do I like to put the word relative there? Because this can be the max, but this one is higher than that. That's why we are comparing this one and this one. That's why we got relative max, relative min. And the other reason why I like to use the word relative there, of course in exam, you write down max and min is good enough. It's because I found this one joke that, anybody here watch Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse? When the guy was late, when the hero was late to the class, the physics class, the teacher said to him, "You are late." And he answers that, "Well, Einstein said time is relative. Maybe I'm not late, maybe you guys are early." And then he tried to date with the older girl. She's hot, Gwen Stacy. And Gwen said, "You know, I'm older than you." And he said, "You know, Einstein said time is relative. But it doesn't matter." Or well, maybe you try to date with someone taller than you. Especially guys, girls doesn't like guys shorter most of the time. You just say, "Oh, I love challenges." Let's see what happens next. I use that pickup line, back pickup lines. I did. Okay, so what about this one? Okay, I give you a try. As you can get so far, we got the critical points 0 and 1. I'm going to say critical point. Points. And then we got ourselves at 0, 0 and negative 1, 1. Right, so we want to check whether they are relative mean or relative max. For you to find them, you need to find. Check at 3 points here, in the middle. On that, in the middle, on right. So what number you put over here? If you want to ask me, I put a negative 5. I like big. You go max, so you don't have to calculate much anymore. So if I put like negative 5, this one here?
Negative 1.
Negative 0.5, very good, because the first time I do this, I put 0.5 and I got a wrong answer. This one here, you can go max 5. You can go 10, not a problem. 100, 1 million, not a problem, but then again, you might want to calculate cube and square. Okay, so now you substitute them inside. You can just use mentally in the head or using calculator. Negative 5 cube is already 125. Negative 125 here is 35. You know this one will be negative. This one is will give you negative answers. Negative 5. This one to negative 125. And at this moment, all teachers will say this one. I'm just testing you. Okay, here you got positive. Here you got negative answers. Substitute them. Just use calculator. I give you a positive, all positive answers. If you are in a higher level, you can just do it this way. You don't even need to calculate it out. Write it out. And we got positive, negative, positive. I can say the graph was something like this. Positive, and then you go negative, and then you go positive again. And you can see relative max, relative min. You guys get it?
Yeah, you might want to write them down in order. Okay, any question? Alright, that's all. Thank you very much for watching. Please comment, share, like and subscribe. How do I get this value? Well, I suck 0 and make this one into the 1. Sorry, my bad. Yeah, I was thinking that it's easy enough. Typically, you start to get. And you got these two values.